Hello everyone, I'm Jharak Patel, Assistant Professor at LJ Institute of Engineering and Technology in the Department of Electronics and Communication. Welcomes you to the session of Power Electronics. Today, I'm going to discuss about Unit 2, that is Control Rectifier, with topic FWCR and its operation and some examples of HWCR in 3 phase. So, let's start the session. First of all, we have taken the one example of 3-phase HWCR. This is a problem statement. Derive the expression for average and RMS value of discontinuous mode HWCR. So, in the last session, we have discussed about the continuous conduction mode of HWCR and discontinuous conduction mode of HWCR. So, in the discontinuous mode of HWCR, the load voltage will be 0 and then again start conducting, while in case of continuous conduction mode of HWCR, it cannot drop to 0 but start conducting after one SCR, the another SCR will start conducting, after SCR 2, SCR 3 will start conducting, but for continuous there will be no voltage drop as 0. So, in the discontinuous conduction mode waveform, we have seen that the waveform will be from 5 by 6 plus alpha to pi. That's why over here we take 1 upon 2 pi by 3 from pi by 6 plus alpha to pi, original v d omega t. In place of v, we will put vm sin omega t. This vm is our phase voltage maximum value. So, now if we integrate this, then we get 3 vm up phase. This Vm maximum voltage, phase voltage is constant, that's why it is out of integration. So it will be written like this: 3 Vm, this denominator part will come into numerator, so it will be like 3 Vm in phase voltage upon 2 pi. Integration of sin omega t, integration of sin is minus cos, that's why it is minus cos omega t. Limit is from pi by 6 plus alpha to pi, that's why over here cos pi by 6 plus alpha minus cos pi. Originally it is minus cos omega cos pi, but cos pi is minus 1 and already negative sign, so it is like this: minus cos pi by 6 plus alpha. It can be written like this because cos pi is minus 1, so minus minus plus, so it is written like this: 3 Vm phase voltage upon 2 pi into 1 plus cos pi by 6 plus alpha. Now, for RMS voltage, this can be written like this: RMS voltage 1 upon 2 pi by 3 as it is, from pi by 6 plus alpha to pi. Here, voltage square will be taken, so Vm square sin square omega t d omega t raised to 1 by 2. So, if we simplify it here, sin square omega t can be written like 1 minus cos 2 omega t divide by 2. So, let's put this sin square omega t, that is 1 minus cos 2 omega t divide by 2 in the above equation. In this equation, we have put these values. So, it is like this. Now, this is the proof or final equation. But if we put this 1 minus cos 2 omega t over here, then it is like this: this Vm square will be out of the integration, so it is like this: Vm square upon 2 pi by 3, integration from pi by 6 plus alpha to pi, 1 minus cos 2 omega t divide by 2. There is no term of 1 present, so simply pi minus pi by 6 plus alpha is there. And the second term, integration of cos 2 omega t, integration of cos is sin 2 omega t divide by 2. That's why over here the term 8 pi is there, and it is like sin pi by 3 plus 2 alpha. Because here in the multiplication 2 is there, that's why over here this 2 will come in the final equation. So this is the final RMS voltage value of HWCR in 3 phase. So, if it is asked in a numerical term, then you have to remember this equation, and you have simply put the values of firing angle in this, so you can get the values of RMS voltage. Now, let's take one another example. 3-phase HWCR has a supply voltage of 110 volt. Find out the mean voltage for delay angle of 150 degree. Delay angle means over here the alpha value is given. Alpha means firing angle is given, because delay angle is also called as a firing angle. Sketch the corresponding waveform, means you have to plot the voltage waveform. So now we use the previous equation, that is DC voltage equation for 3-phase HWCR, that is, you can also write 1 upon 2 pi by 3 Vm of line voltage into cos alpha. So it can be written like this, 3 Vm divided by 2 pi cos alpha. Now if you put the values, it is like this. Here, here Vm is the line voltage. It can be written like line voltage equal to root 3 times phase voltage that we have seen in the last lecture. The relation in star connection and delta connection. So we have put these values from this. So here maximum voltage is asked, but in the question RMS voltage is mentioned. So RMS voltage is 110 volt, so maximum voltage is root 2 times RMS voltage. That's why it is written root 3 into root 2 times 110. So maximum voltage is our 269.4 volt. So this is our maximum line voltage. Now if we put the value of maximum line voltage over here, maximum line voltage value 269.4, if we put this in this equation, then it is written like this, 3 into 269.4 divided by 2 pi cos alpha. Now the value of alpha is given, that is 150. So if we put the value 150 over here and calculate, then it is minus 114.4 volt. So this is the our final answer for mean voltage. Now for 150 degree, if we plot the waveform, it is like this, because at a time only one SCR will be turned on and firing angle is 150. So after the interval of 150, the crossover point should be there. So these are our crossover points that you can see. In the theory we have discussed that the point A, C and E are the zero crossover points, so you can also name it as A, C and E point in HWCR. So whatever the firing angle, you simply put it at a crossover point, zero crossover point, and plot the graph. So it is like this. You can also mention the value of voltage over here, this Vm voltage value that we have calculated, you can put it over here. So these are the examples of HWCR. Now let's see full converter. In the front phase circuit we have seen that the full converter is operated in a two quadrant. So here also in case of 3-phase full converter, it operates in a two quadrant operation. We will discuss about this, that how it can be operated in a two quadrant. It has a structure of 3 diodes and 3 SCR. In the half wave control rectifier we have seen that it has either 3 SCR or either 3 diodes, but not 3 diodes and 3 SCR simultaneously, but over here 3 diodes and 3 SCRs are connected. Because of this construction, it provides controlled rectification purpose. The circuit diagram is like this. Here you can see that the 3 SCRs are connected. Here if the diodes are connected, then it provides the operation of uncontrolled full converter. But here the SCRs are there, so it provides controlled rectification purpose. Here at a time only 2 diodes will be operated, either from S1, S2 and S3. This S1, S2, S3, any one diode will operate it, and in this S4, S4, S5 and S6, from this S4, S5 and S6, any one diode will operate it. So at a time, any one diode from these 3 or these 3 will be operated. So simultaneously 2 diodes operation will be taken place in case of full converter, and that's why its operation is in a 2 quadrant. We discuss about it in a detail later on. Now, what will be the output frequency? So, if one SCR is used, so by default it operates at a 50 Hz supply. So, here 6 SCRs are used, so it is 6 into 50. So, around 300 Hz output frequency for full converter. So, we can discuss about the full converter for two different loads, resistive load and resistive and inductive load. So, let's start with inductive load first. Here we have taken another circuit diagram. If we take the case of 2 HWCR that is made for conducting full wave controlled rectifier purpose, here you can see that this first HWCR and this is second HWCR. So here full converter with two half converter is shown. Now, full converter operating with highly inductive load, it is capable of operating in two different quadrants. Here, two different quadrants operation is depend on the firing angle. Now, if this firing angle is less than 90 degree, then it provides rectification. And if firing angle is greater than 90 degree, then it provides the purpose of inversion. Now, how it will take place, that we see in the operation of full converter. First of all, when firing angle is less than 90 degree. So now when firing angle is less than 90 degree, the waveform will be like this. Here at a time only two diodes will operate. So here you can see that in a 6 intervals it is divided. So at a time here, please note that if one first SCR is conducting, then the other SCR is 5. Here again first SCR is conducting, then the sixth SCR is conducted. Here with two second SCR, sixth SCR, and again fourth second SCR, fourth SCR is conducted. So this is how the conduction will take place. And if you note the load voltage waveform for this firing angle 90 degree, then you can note that here only positive load voltage will be there, no negative voltage, or even if it is there, then also it has some very low value. So we can easily say that the source to load voltage is more than the load to source voltage. So in that case, the power flow from source to load is also more compared to power flow from load to source. So this is how the rectification will be done in case of full converter. This is how DC is converted into AC. Here line commutation is used for turn off, means at a time if one SCR is conducting, then after finishing this conduction only the second SCR will start conducting. After one SCR will be turned off, then second SCR will start conducting. This is called as a line commutation. This will happen for firing angle less than 90 degree. Now let's see another case. When firing angle equal to 90 degree. So in that case, again note that 6 interval is there, but here if you note the load voltage waveform, then it is exactly divided into half. Please note this dark section here and here. These two sections are of equal amount and in any interval. So we can say that power flow from load to source is equal to power flow from source to load. That means if we put the equation of VLDC, then also if alpha equal to 90, then cos 90 will become 0. And this is how the average load voltage is 0. Now if average load voltage is 0, then we can say that the power flow is also 0. And because of that, energy stored from load to source is equal to energy stored from source to load. So this is the second case, which is when firing angle is equal to 90 degree. Now let's take the third case, when firing angle becomes greater than 90 degree. In that case, power flow from load to source becomes greater than source to load. This is how you can see that the negative portion becomes more compared to the positive portion, or even we can say that positive portion is almost negligible as compared to negative portion. Even you can also prove this using the equation VLDC, that if you put the value alpha greater than 90, either 110 or 120 degree, then the VLDC will becomes negative, and this is how you can prove that the inversion will taken place in that case. So this is the inversion case. So this is our operation of full wave converter. You can also see that this full wave converter that we seen this in the circuit diagram is using bridge configuration, that six SCRs are connected. If it is said in the exam that draw the circuit diagram of full converter without controlled operation, then you have to simply put diodes instead of SCR, so that it can not provide us controlled rectification or maybe controlled inversion process. So this is the end of our operation of full wave converter. In the next session, we discuss about some analysis and examples related to it. Up to this, if you have any query or doubt, you can ask me on my WhatsApp number. Thank you for watching.